terwijl je wegduwt, hè, duw ook maar met je bovenbeen een beetje in die rol.
So it's now the 26th of June. On the 26th of May I had my accident and I haven't walked on my foot since. So
it's normal that it feels weird to use it, or it's normal that it feels weird if I give some pressure there.
I'm nervous.
Yeah, makes sense, right?
Like sweaty hands.
Yeah.
Ik zou van het bankje afspringen met twee van.
Dat zou niet de eerste zijn.
Nee.
Nee, natuurlijk. Oké. Okay. Nogmaals, Martijn, het doel is niet om nu 100% of laten we zeggen, al is het 50% daarop te staan.
Doe ik nu.
Maar dat doe je al. Oké. Okay. Nou, dan is het doel gehaald. Gaan we weer zitten.
Ja, ik stand. It feels really weird.
Oké. Okay. Ja, dus wat je ziet is dat je.
Look at the sweaty hands.
Ja. Het enige wat ik wil dat je doet, is dat je een beetje je gewicht verplaatst met steun. Dus tussen links en rechts.
Zo.
Ja, dat is een beetje sway, zeg maar. Hè,
van ik ken nu alles op één.
Nee, gozer.
Ja, weet ik veel. Ik ben juist bang als ik...
Nee, maar wat... Hey, wacht even. Oké, kom even stop, pauze. Rechterbeen omhoog. Even luisteren. Oké, dus de opdracht was... Verplaats je gewicht rustig heen en weer. En ik was al niet uitgesproken of je staat op één been. Wat op zich heel goed is. Hoe fijn dat het kan. Maar het is belangrijk om rustig daar naartoe te gaan. Ja. Chill.
Hele zweet.
Je gaat zo snel, ouwe. Je gaat zo snel.
Maar dat doet wel pijn.
Ja,
omdat ik hem niet omlaag heb.
Ja. Dus, weet je wel. Even take it easy.
Ik stond net gewoon één tel op mijn rechterbeen. This is the first time I used my right leg after a move.
Die beelden moeten voor mij ook, moeten ook als goede professional overkomen. En zo'n mensen zien we twee weken meteen lekker op één been staan. Sta ik ook voor lul. Ja, dus hier zie je de... Ja, dat is heel duidelijk, hè? Zie je de contouren van de... Dit is het overige... Het goede been. Ja, dus hier zie je gewoon de contouren van de pees. En hier is het gewoon nog heel dik, zie je? Dus hier aan de achterkant, daar. En daarna zie je dat de spiermassa is natuurlijk flink afgenomen.
And yesterday, to be honest, I had a super shit day. It was really painful. We did some workouts, but then... I ended up taking painkillers again, because it was just...
You also hit your foot against the machine.
Yeah. I hit my foot. At the place where the stitches were. So that wasn't helpful.
Dat was
echt. Because I'm an idiot. Tour starts next week. I'm going to start doing the shows with the brace that's over there. I don't want to be on stage for the first time again. Or behind CDJs after a month. Like on a thing that I don't really know how to stand on yet. So I want to practice. This is called Game Ready. We're gonna call it Show Ready. It basically pumps ice cold water around my foot and ankle. So the more blood, the more oxygen, and the quicker the recovery. So lots of icing. It's fucking cold. So today I invited some friends because it's 2 days before I'm my first show back again, and to be honest I'm really nervous because I have no idea what my leg is gonna do. So I was like, why don't I just throw a party at my house? I have a DJ booth and I'm basically gonna stand and see how long into my set I will start having pain or how my ankle will be after the show. It's gonna be not like a real show, of course, but I think this also will give a clear insight of how ready I am for the show on Thursday. How? Oh, fuck. I'm a little nervous because it's not just one show on Thursday, it's the rest of the summer tour starts. And we have a really crazy summer tour ahead. I think we do 5 shows a week, so I think it'll be fine, but just mentally I want to know we are ready for the crazy summer ahead.
Deze man met
hij er net van de door schiet. Nee, omdat je natuurlijk, je hebt die boel, ja, die zit op 90. Nee, maar nu heb je dat je tegen Darsje aan zit, maar daar...
Hij moet niet vastkomen, het zit er onder de ring. Als ik hem opdraai.
We're gonna test out if I get a lot of pain when I'm standing for such a long time. We shortened the set time a little bit at Ushuaia from 2 hours to 1.5. But I think today we'll find out if it's really necessary. I'm just grateful I get to be back on stage, play music, let the music do the work.
It replicates very well how it feels when I'm on stage. No, it feels good. I felt great in the beginning.
Now my foot really hurts. It's a little less than an hour and a half. I think an hour 15 in, it started to really hurt. But yeah, I'm still positive. I think I also have a lot of adrenaline, you know. But it's really painful now. I need to ice it.
Oh, that's the 1 hour 30 minutes alarm.
I don't know if it was mission succeeded, but at least the third part I had a first part I had a lot of energy, so I don't know. I really don't. I do think I have a lot of adrenaline whenever I play from the crowd, you know.
Ah, doet echt tyfus veel pijn hier.
Kijk, als hij nou morgen super dik is en heel veel pijn doet, ja, dan weet je dat je vandaag echt te veel hebt gedaan. Dus dat moeten we eigenlijk morgen weten we meer, ja. What the least ideal situation would be is that he does the show and that the day after the ankle is really sore and swollen because then you need to recover again and then there's the next show and then the next day, you know, it goes day in, day out, it goes like that. It's crisis management, you know, if it goes like that and we want to build him up. So yeah, that's there's no way of knowing now how that's gonna progress. So I think the real focus is on recovery. Because we know we can't really, you know, not do the shows. So sleep, diet, movement, the icing, the compression, all these little things together hopefully gives enough space to, you know, get some room for building him up.
Positieve kant, het zijn maar 100 shows deze zomer. Zo voorbij.
Almost forgot that one. Going to Ibiza. I think I'm ready. I'm so excited to be back on stage. You have no idea. It's been like 6 weeks or something. My I'm happy to be back on stage. I only need one shoe. I'm gonna play this one for the first time tonight.
It's a new one.
New one.
You made these days?
3 weeks ago.
And one day he wrote me on Instagram. It was so fun. I was like, "Whoa, Martin Garrix!" I said, "I would never expect that."
Well, we already met, or like briefly at some festivals, and it was always very quickly. What I always like I'm all about good energy, and I got great energy from Joseph. So I was like, "Man, come to Amsterdam, we'll hang out." Yeah. And then
come to my house. I was like, "Whoa, really?" You know, I was shy. You know, I said, "No, come on." And then, you know, I said, "Man, you know, this is family vibe." And, I love it. Yeah. It's not about what you play, it's all about the spirit and how you do something, you know. It's, you know, music for me is it's a mission, you know, to make people dance and unite the people. He does the same and even much better, you know. Come on. We're just friends. And music unites us. Always.
Yes.
Heb je alles bij je?
Ja, allemaal pillen, ik heb 1 schoen, die heb ik maar nodig.
Ja. Heb je ook sokken bij? Nee.
Ja. En daarmee kan ik 6 keer optreden. Shocks or electricity through my legs.
How was it?
Amazing.
How you felt?
Amazing.
Wow, wow.
Really, amazing. Really,
really. I don't know how you did, but really don't know.
And
jumping and dancing and everything.
Is dat ook? Ik heb helemaal geen last niks. Ik heb helemaal geen last niks.
Ik heb eigenlijk zo snel mogelijk naar
je kamer gaan. Ik
wil een kijkje.
Ja, kijk dan. Ik dribbel, daar staat weer op. Ik wil even onderhouden.
Ja, dat is goed. Maar ik denk, slim voor jou.
Maar je bent niet te delen in de groen.
Belangrijk, deze eerste momenten. Dat we zo snel mogelijk kijken hoe alles. Er komen nog heel veel greenrooms aan, hè?
Ja, maar vanavond is iedereen er.